Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Sadaqallahu alazim. When a scholar such as Mevlana Sheikh Hisham comes to visit you, then you ask some questions that not many people can answer, and you don't find the answer in the books available. So this is one such opportunity for me, at least, to request kindly Mevlana Sheikh Hisham to help us understand one ayat, one verse. When I was reading an article about Salat, the author who has written that article included in it this incident that happened in Medina. This took place in the masjid of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A companion, Abu Sa'id ibn Mubarak, he was praying some prayer in the masjid, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called upon him to come to him. He invited him. Since he was praying, he wanted to finish, so he delayed his coming to the Prophet, responding to the Prophet. So when he finished, he went to the Prophet, apologized for being late, and the Prophet said, Abu Sa'id, don't you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayat? And then the Prophet quoted this ayat, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanustajibu lillahi walir rasuli idha da'akum lima yuhyikum. And I think he quoted this much, but the ayat continues, wa'lamu anna allaha yahulu baynal mar'i wa qalbihi wa annahu ilayhi tuhsharun. Sadaqallahu alazim. And we would like to request Mevlana Sheikh Hisham to explain to us what are the secrets, what is the meaning of this significant ayat that the Prophet reminded his companion of the importance of this ayat and kind of reprimanded him for not coming right away. That's the question. I don't know. I don't know.
Yeah. ensemble sing unity.
Thank you.
Thank you. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. وعليكم
السلام ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه. ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله عليه أفضل الصلاة والتسليم. أما بعد، أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون، هذا الحبيب المصطفى عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام الذي أرسله رحمة للعالمين وشفيعا للمذنبين، نرجو أن يتشفع لنا في الدنيا وفي الآخرة، وأن يكون معنا في الدنيا وفي الآخرة، وأن ينظرنا بنظرة المحبة والعفو والرضا. It's a pleasure and honor to be here today in this generous house and in the presence of Imam Sanad and everyone else, especially Sheikh Abdul Haq, Sheikh Sahib, Ali, and the Zahra Ensemble. They're trying their best to make people with your songs, with their songs, with his songs, to make people to listen to how much those authors of these songs were in a trance of love to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it shows us how much difference between them and us. How much we are muqassirin, inefficient, and how much they were efficient in Allah's love and Prophet's love. Maulana Imam Sanad has asked a question about tafsir of one ayah. It is not me that I can make tafsir, explanation of the ayah, because I am not that one who deserves that place. There is struggle in everyone. There is struggle between good and bad, between good desire and bad desires, between good ego and bad ego. Also, there is a struggle in every person, in me also. So always I have to be careful to express myself and say I am not worthy except to be with the shoes at the door. Not more than that. Or else, immediately Shaitan will enter. And he is lana bil mirsad.
Ready and waiting.
He is ready and waiting. Ambush. No one is able to be away from his ambush except whom Allah is happy with them. either you are with the with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has asked us to do and listen to him, or on the other side, which is the dark side, to listen to what our ego is saying and what our shaitans are saying to us. And no one can say, I have no shaitan. Only Prophet ﷺ, he said, I have aslamtu shaitani. I have made my shaitan Muslim. Although Prophet ﷺ, we know all of us from the seerah of Al-Mawlid al-Nabawi al-Sharif, that Jibreel alayhi salam came and opened his heart. Open heart surgery. Better than 1400 years ago, Allah has showed us that first open heart surgery was with for Prophet ﷺ to take what? To take the house, the place where shaitan enters in the heart. And that surgery, of course, has to, as today they break all the bones in the chest, doctor, and they go to the heart, they open the heart, and they do what they want to do. A 1400 years ago, Allah is showing us miracles that this Habibi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not necessary for doctors of anesthesia, not for you. They don't need. By Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, the chest open. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, the heart open. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, that piece being taken out, and Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, it closed back. So we have to choose where to go. Now, in this room, if you put this light off, can you see anything? Nothing. You put the switch on, we can see each other. So what makes us to see each other?
Light.
Light. No light, you cannot see. Big Bang, before Big Bang, everything was in Adam. Adam means not existing and incomplete, you cannot see anything. Unseen. Nothingness, yeah. Al-amal mutlaq. The absolute nothingness. That you cannot see anything. And suddenly, everything broke. And in a gaseous form, producing by Allah's order all different planets, and they are, and you can, and the light came. So before that Big Bang, the light was ready to come out, and then you can see. And by Allah's order, it came out. And then everything was able to see. قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وكتاب مبين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent light and the Holy Quran. He's mentioned light before. We are coming to your question. قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ. From Allah came light and the Holy Quran. The light that came by all scholars, they say is the light of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Holy Quran. In the presence of the divine presence, because the Holy Quran is Kalamullah, Allah's words, is not created. So it is, if it is not created, it is that the Quran is in the divine presence, is divine. Nurun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah created Nurun Nabi. قبضت قبضة من نوري قلت لها كوني محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. I took one hand of my light and say to that light, be Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's why hadith of Jabir in Musannaf Abd al-Razzaq, first volume, says that what Allah has created first was the light of Prophet. So that light, if was not there, there will be darkness. The light took away darkness. And that light, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allama al-Quran, al-Rahman, allama al-Quran, khalaqa al-insan. Allah taught Quran, created a human being after. So who taught Quran to whom? Quran is meant for Bani Adam. To whom? To Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to the light of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Means Prophet already before creation of a human being is being under the divine words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from Holy Quran. And when Allah says allama al-Quran, taught the Holy Quran, will not leave anything without teaching. When you teach a class in the school, can you read half of the book and then half of the book you say is finished the class? You cannot. You have to finish the whole semester, the whole book, what you are teaching, physics, chemistry, anything. You cannot go halfway. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah with his love to his Prophet, didn't give him halfways. All the way to the end. And since there is no end for the divine words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no end for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam keep a taking from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divine words. For us, you read the ayah, is you understand what you understand, that's it. But what is that ayah doesn't stop. The meaning continue. Awliya Allah can take, because Prophet is taking and giving to them. Depend on their levels. So that light is what is important. Light is known, is Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahu nuru samawati wal ard. Mathalu nurihi kamishkatin fiha misbah. Allah is the light of heavens and earth, but the example of His light, Allah is explaining. The example of His light, مَثَلُ نُورِهِ كَمِشْكَاتٍ فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٍ, is a bundle of lights. Is a bundle of what?
Lights.
Of light. كَمِشْكَاتٍ, مِشْكَات in Arabic, is bundle, is not?
Niche.
Niche? No, not yet. What's Mishkat?
Bundle, like
Call it niche? Okay, niche, what you call it? Bundle? Mishkat is a bundle. Niche is like a mihrab. Bundle of lights. Kamishkatin fiha misbah. It's all from lights. In the middle there is a lamp. كمشكات فيها مصباح المصباح في زجاجة. مصباح is what in Arabic? Is lantern that gives light. That light is in a crystal glass. But Allah explained what's that glass. كأنه كوكب دري. الله is like a planet made of pearls, shining continuously, non-stopping. So the bundle is Allah, is Nuru Samawati wal Ard. The bundle is the light, but different lights. And in that middle of these different lights, which we can see, how many lights you can see? Seven? Seven lights, physics. Seven lights. From the purple, white, purple, red. They know it. I forgot it this long time ago. Until it goes to black. Bundle of light, the middle of that light is the lamp. That lamp, كأنها كوكب دري, is like a pearl, a planet of pearl, دري, shining. يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية. يوقد من شجرة مباركة. That light, it's fueled or ignited by a blessed tree, olive tree, which has meaning, لا شرقية, not eastern, and not western. Because always Kaaba or اتجاه الكعبة, either east or west. East, west, in the main. We don't say north and south, always east-west. So that light is Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the prophetic light. Is that all? Or there is beyond? So we acknowledge now, as Holy Quran said, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا. You are a lamp, misbah, lantern, shining. قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ. So the Prophet ﷺ is established in between Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah is the light. What Allah has created first is what? Is the light of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Can you see all lights? When there is a rain and the sun, and the sun is shining and rain dropping on the earth, you will see Kausu Kazah, the rainbow. What you can see from light is limited. You cannot see everything. The light, if that is the light, continuously, you cannot see except this. You cannot see here, what is here. There is light here. There is light here. There is light here. There is light here. But our capacity of seeing is between, in physics, between 0.4 and 0.8 of a micron. Micron is the one of the smallest, smaller than atom is a micron. 0.4, the limits that you can see, the width of the light that you can see is 0.4, 0.8 to 0.4. Under 0.4 you cannot see, under 0.8 you cannot see. And it is in fraction of a measurement, 0.4 micron. Micron is the measurement in physics in the smallest possible particle that you can imagine, smaller than atom. So our vision is restricted between these two measurements, 0.4 and 0.8 micron. That's why we cannot see the ultraviolet light, because it is beyond 0.4, beyond 0.8. But who can see it? The bees. Bees can see that light. Beyond 0.4, beyond 0.8, they can see. So means here, if for you cannot see, means darkness. Dark for you. Here, dark for you. So you cannot see except what is within this limitation. On the side you cannot see, but the bees can see. We can say bees better than human being? That they can see? No. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given Ummatul Nabi, to those who listen to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu استجيبوا لله ولرسوله. Oh, أولياء الله, because of your listening to Allah and His Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, He gave you something that يحييكم, to bring you up to حياة أبدية, to eternal life. Give you an eternal life. He called them already al-mu'minun. Allah called them those. لا تقولوا آمنا.
قالت الأعراب آمنا. قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قولوا أسلمنا. ولما يدخل الإيمان في قلوبكم وإن تطيعوا الله ورسوله لا يلتكم من أعمالكم شيئا إن الله عليم خبير.
قالت الأعراب آمنا means the Bedouins, who their mind is restricted. آمنا, we believed. He said no. Don't say that. Say we are Muslim, aslamna. Still iman, you didn't reach the level of iman. In to reach level of iman, ita'atullah wa rasuli. Continuation of the ayah, to obey Allah and His Prophet. When you reach that level, then you can say amanna. Who obey Allah and His Prophet? أولياء الله. Since they reach that level, ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. My saints, there are nothing to fear or to be sad because they can see. They can see beyond 0.4, less than 0.4, and less than 0.8, and more than 0.8. They can see what you cannot see. كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِي وَبَصَرُهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِي. I will be his ears that he can hear with. I will give him vision. I will be his eyes that he can see with. What to see? What people cannot see. Means a wali can see beyond 0.4 and more, beyond also you say 0.8. And beyond 0.4 is the seeing of things that normal people are unable to see or understand. What is beyond 0.4, as we said, 0.8? Is continuation of the light of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because Prophet brought light to darkness, took away darkness and make it to be seen. But there are limitation only for awliya Allah that they can see more. That's why a wali can tell you what you can give you something that Allah cures you from any sickness. Can tell you what you need to do. Can not by him seeing himself, I am doing that. No, he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah said in ayah, أَيَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَجِيبُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلْرَّسُولِ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ. Answer. Because he did not answer. He was praying and the Prophet called him. He was supposed to drop the prayer. Because when Prophet calls, you have to listen to Prophet, not listen anymore to your prayer. إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ. If he calls you, he was going to give you secrets. He was going to open for you. You were supposed to break your prayer and see what he is going to give you. Because what he wants to give you is something that he wants to rejuvenate you. When Zachariah in Surah Maryam, قال ربي قال ربي هب لي من كافها يا عصاب من عمدك هذا واشتعل الرأس شيبا ولم أكن بدعائك ربي شقيا فهب لي من لدنك وليا. الله said, سيدنا زكريا said in Surah Maryam, oh Allah, after his bones were ruined, going to be in ruins, he was 99 years of age. He said, Ya Rabbi, hab li min ladunka waliya, grant me from yours a child, someone to follow the message. His wife, Yasara, was 90 years. Not Sarah. Her name, Yasara. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ahya. He rejuvenated, he created back Sayyidina Zakaria to have power. When he was saying to Jibreel alayhi salam, how I am going to have a child? When Allah said, okay, you are going to have a child, he said to Jibreel alayhi salam, how I am going to have a child? And inni wahana al-'azmu minni wa ishta'ala al-ra'su shayba. I became white hair and wahana al-'azmu minni, my bones finished. Huh? Weak bones. And my wife, 90 years of age, what? he said he took a piece of dry branch of a tree, and as soon as he was looking, Sayyidina Zakaria, he saw two leaves, green leaves, that in Tafsir al-Quran, two leaves. He said, as Allah rejuvenated back this stick, Allah will rejuvenate you and your wife back. استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم. Allah said, ادعوني أستجب لكم. سيدنا زكريا make the dua. Allah accept. استجاب. استجاب. He accepted to make dua. People today, they don't make dua and they say, we have this problem and this problem and this problem. Go and make dua. Keep doing dua. Non-stop. Allah said, ادعوني أستجب لكم. Call on me, I will give you what you want. We call one time, two times, three times, and we stop. So he rejuvenate Sarah, Yasara, and Zakaria. So he gave him what to Zakaria? Hayat, life. And gave Yasara Hayat. So when the boy came, since it was a miracle of Hayat, miracle of life, Allah called him Yahya. Ya from his mother, he took the Ya from the mother and he put it, means the egg, Ya. The last word in the alphabet, letter in the alphabet, he put it together with Hayat, and Sayyidina Yahya came out. Because Sayyidina Zakaria stajaba lillahi walirrasuli, he accepted, he responded to what he been ordered, ad'uni أستجب لكم. So, and look at the ayah. His Highness is His Nobility, Noble Imam Sanad. يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله ولرسوله استجيبوا لله وللرسول. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, amanu in plural. Stajibu in plural. Everyone means people. Lillahi walil rasuli idha da'akum. Idha da'akum goes back to whom? If lillahi wa lirrasul, it will be da'ukum, in plural. Da'ukum, if it is plural. But here it's two. Is da'awakuma, da'awkuma. Da'awkuma means for that if they both Allah and His Prophet, but He said, "Da'akum, ay lil Rasul." Yani, call on Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ida da'akum al Rasul, lillah Allah yastajib. Lima yuhyikum, to what you are in need to be gives you life. And then when He gives you that power, you'll be able to see what is beyond point 4 and point 8 that physicists today cannot see beyond that figure, point 4 and point 8. But the light of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is everywhere. If there is no light of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you cannot see. That's why you look at him, you can see people, you can see anything, the world, because it is falling into the 0.0.8. What beyond 0.0.8? What is there? What is here? This here, this vacuum here, it's beyond 0.0.4 or 0.8. But we cannot see unless if we become ما زال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه. As long as my servant approaches me through voluntary worshipness, I love him. Love can make you to see and to hear what people cannot see and people cannot hear. Hadith of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به وبصره الذي يبصر به. The ears that he can hear with, the eyes that he can see with, the tongue that he can speak with, the hand that he can take or move with, the feet that he can walk with. Continue the ayah.
وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَحُولُ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَقَلْبِهِ وَأَنَّهُ إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ
يَحُولُ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَقَلْبِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you answer, when استجيبوا لله ولرسوله وللرسول إذا دعاكم, at that moment Allah يَحُولُ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَقَلْبِهِ. Allah will immediately يحول, get in between you and your heart. He drops yourself, your ego, your desires, because you have responded to Allah and His Prophet, and He will dress you from the divine dresses and manifest on you His beautiful names and attributes. You appear now that you be able to see beyond the limitation that human beings are limited to. You can see what people cannot see, you can hear what people cannot hear, because you are rejuvenated as Zakaria was rejuvenated, as his wife was rejuvenated, and get Yahya. Yahya is Hayat. Allah called him Yahya from Haya. Haya is Hayat. Added to it the ya to make it a noun, and Allah gave him Yahya, means that the symbol of anyone who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring him from rejuvenating what? Man and woman. But here, rejuvenating yourself means Allah is giving you, يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول. If you respond to Allah, Allah will give you hayat. If you respond to Prophet, Allah gives you hayat. So responding to them is a necessity. وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه. Whatever Prophet gives you, take it. وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا. What he prohibits you to do, stop. What Prophet? وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Prophet ﷺ is giving you what? Not only giving you, don't do this, he is giving you مَأْمُورَاتْ وَمَنْهِيَاتْ. Stop doing prohibitions and do what is necessary to be done. Just now, he was reading the ayah at the beginning. رَبِّ شْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَأَحْلُلْ عُقْدَةً مِّن لِسَانِي يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي وَاجْعَلْ لِي وَزِيرًا مِّنْ أَهْلِي هَارُونَ أَخِي أُشْدُدْ بِهِ أَزْرِي أَشْرِكُ فِي أَمْرِكَ كَيْ نُسَبِّحَكَ كَثِيرًا وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَثِيرًا إِنَّكَ كُنْتَ بِنَا بَصِيرًا. That's Sayyidina Musa. What he was saying? Oh Allah, expand my chest. What Prophet said? Sayyidina Musa coming, asking, oh Allah, open, expand my chest. He is Kareemullah. Sayyidina Musa went to Tur Sinai and said, Ya Rabbi, I am Kalimullah, I am yours that you speak to, Kalim, talking. And Muhammad is Habibullah. So Ya Rabbi, what is the difference between Kalimullah and Habibullah? He said, Ya Musa, Kalimullah, the one that talked to Allah, because he didn't have Jibreel, directly he was talking. Kalimullah is the one that he does things, his yurdi mawla, for to please his Lord pleasure, to make his Lord happy. He does things to make his Lord happy. But Habibullah, Ya Musa, whom Allah wants to make his Habib happy, he does things. I do for my Habib anything to make him happy. But you, Kalimullah, you do everything to make me happy. Big difference. Rabbi Shrahli Sadri is asking, or expand my chest. Alam Nashrah Laka Sadrak, for Prophet. And we are coming to it. He said, Ya Musa, Kareemullah has to come to me to Tur Sinai to speak with me. But Habibullah, I let him to sleep and dream and bring him to Qaba Qawsayn aw Adna. I bring him to me, but you come to me. But him, I bring him. There is big difference. Sayyidina Musa said, Rabbi shrah li sadri, expand my chest, wassir li amri, and make my way is easy to you. Wahlul uqdatan min lisani, untie the knot that it is on my tongue. Yafqahu qawli, by this way they can understand what I have to give them your message. But for Prophet, what Allah said, Alam nashrah laka sadrak? We didn't. By myself, I did it for you, Ya Muhammad, because I love you. I expanded your chest. I gave you what you want. Alam nashrah laka sadrak? Wada'na anka wizrak? And took all your sins. Although Prophet doesn't have sins, but we are not going to explain that now. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ الَّذِي أَنْقَضَ ظَهْرَكَ The burden that was on your shoulder, we took it, lifted up. Means we lifted up what you are asking us in every moment. You feel that your ummah, I gave you ummah that they like to make too much sins, and I am happy to forgive them all. So what you want more than that? I'm doing this for you as my Habib. But for Musa, he has to struggle. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his tongue was not, no, didn't have uqda in his not in his mouth. Allah gave him easy way to talk. His talk is وَالنَّجْمِ إِذَا هَوَى مَا ضَلَّ صَاحِبُكُمْ وَمَا غَوَى وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. He doesn't open. Nutuk is from here, from the throat, is not? Comes from here and it goes up. Even if he is is wahy. Anything that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam come from his mouth sound is wahy, revelation. He didn't give the, and Sayyidina Musa, he said, open my, take the knot that it's on my tongue. All this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put it for all of us. The condition of opening your eyes and your ear for what is lima yuhyikum, to what it is necessary to open your eyes and ears and rejuvenate you and give you a heavenly life, is by responding to Allah and His Prophet. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open for us.
Ameen, ya
Rabbi. And give Ummatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the highest level of paradises.
Ameen.
And give us also, because of their shafa'ah, of shafa'atul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, give us also from ya Rabbi, make Prophet to make shafa'ah for us.
Ameen.
With his shafa'ah we be able to be with him. Ameen. And to enter paradise with him. To speak, our scholars around the world, they can speak. One time I came to Grand Sheikh, I have a question like his question, like Imam Sanad question. The ayah in the Holy Quran says, Allahu Akbar. وَلِكُلِّنْ وِجْهَةٌ هُوَ مُوَلِّيهَا فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. For everyone there is a direction, has to follow and compete in the best. Try to compete in your way and his way and her way, always running toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, may Allah give him long life.
Ameen.
We were sitting in Beirut, he was in Beirut, in our home, and reading that ayah, and I am saying to him about that ayah, وَلِكُلِّنْ وِجْهَةٌ هُوَ مُوَلِّيهَا فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَةِ. Everyone has a way to compete. I said, Mawlana, what it applies on me? And he said, go and ask Grand Chief. When we went to Damascus after 2-3 days visiting Grand Sheikh, Mawlana was at Beirut. He was at that time, there was a problem, a war in Syria, so he cannot go for certain reasons. So I went and came up happy to ask. Mawlana Sheikh Nazim told me, ask. And I said, Sayyidi, what the meaning of the ayah? وَلِكُلِّنْ وِجْهَةٌ هُوَ وَلِّيَا فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. He looked at me, he said, Ya Waladi, here there is no questions. If you want to know the tafsir of the ayah, there is Sheikh Ahmed Koftaro, the Mufti of Syria, go to him, ask him. They will tell you the meaning. Here, these meanings doesn't apply here. Here the meanings are, no wali can explain the meaning of the ayat of Holy Quran. And the example is the hadith of Prophet. When Jibreel came to him and said, Surah Maryam, Kaf, Ha ya Ain Sad. He was saying Kaf, you want to continue Ha? Prophet said, Alimtu. Answer them, I knew. He said, Ha? He said, Alimtu. Ya Alimtu. Before Jibreel telling him what, Jibreel said, I was surprised. I am telling him reading and he said, I knew. Means I knew before you, ya Jibreel. عين علمته، صاد علمته، كاف ها يا عين صاد علمته. On every letter means every letter has a meaning. It's a code. Every letter in Holy Quran is by itself a code in the world. Kaf ha ya ain sad has a meaning. But scholars has written books on these meanings. But there are meanings that beyond the limitation, beyond the knowledge of scholars. If you want to go deep in the Holy Quran, Sayyidina Sheikh Sharafuddin went in Surah Al-An'am wa min abayihim.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. ومن آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم وإخوانهم واجتبيناهم وهديناهم إلى صراط مستقيم.
Before. That from their grandchildren, descendants and offsprings, اجتبيناهم وهديناهم. We chose them and we guided them. And he said from these two ayat, Sheikh Sharafuddin was able to extract Awliya Allah's name. He extracted the most important one, Khulafa Sayyidina al-Mahdi, Nawab Sayyidina al-Mahdi, Rijal al-Ishraqiyun, Al-A'imma al-Mudabbirun, Mashayikh al-Islam, five different groups. He extracted all their names, around 400 names. More than 400 names. By extraction these names, it become heavy on his heart because he was deep in entering, diving in the meaning of Holy Quran in these two verses. Was able to get their names from these two verses. We have these names. In 3 months, his heart began to weaken, and left dunya. But he gave the book to Maulana Sheikh Nazim, Maulana Sheikh Abdullah. So, it's not easy to go deep into the meaning, diving into the meaning of the verses of Holy Quran. If there is no permission, it becomes difficult on you. That's why some people, they say, change your name. That name is heavy on you. Because they can see that it's heavy. Because your parents dive in to get a special name which does not apply to you, you might have problems. So we have to be very careful in diving without permission. We will be under a difficulty. Like the light, you see one light, white light. But in reality, if there is drop of rain and the earth is wet, you see Kazakh on seven lights, seven different colors. This is within 0.4, 0.8. What is beyond 0.4, beyond 0.8, it will be infinite number of colors, infinite number of, in one light, infinite number of colors that Awliya Allah can see. So it was a nice opening from Imam Sanad, mashallah, he's always he's a big alim, and inshallah, Allah make it easy for them to get a place. And may Allah forgive us and bless us. There is before they asked me to mention about this CD of our maestro, Ali. is a new album, other than the last one. It's in a different, very nice one. You can find it on the table there. They are selling it for $15, is not? We give him a free one too. This is, you know, everyone they see on the roads, your tax money. What it's called?
Tax money at work.
Yeah, your donation at work. This is what we are, with your donation, what we are doing. You can get it from the table there. Who we are meeting, who we are spreading Islam to, who we are advising, what we are doing with government, it is inside that album. Whoa. And this is for the Hajj album that we went last year, 12, 11 we went. No, 12, 14, 32. 1432, no, whatever, 2 years. Is, yeah, 1 year and a half. So if you want it, this is, they are selling it there. So, because it's costed a lot. It has all the picture of the people that went to Hajj with me last time. So this is would be for those who are interested. It is there on the table. You can buy it at any moment. Wa min Allahi tawfiq, Sheikh Imam.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم إنا نسألك إيمانا دائما ونسألك قلبا خاشعا ونسألك علما نافعا ونسألك يقينا صادقا ونسألك دينا قيما ونسألك العافية من كل بلية ونسألك تمام العافية ونسألك دوام العافية ونسألك الشكر على العافية ونسألك الغنى عن الناس وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله أجمعين الطيبين الطاهرين والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين
الفاتحة
Bring the food here, people.
Okay, no problem.
Oh.
واغفر لي عبدك في الدارين صبرا متى تدعوه الأوال يا نهزيم مولاي
صلى الله عليه وسلم على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم في بيته طيبة حرام واسمه قاسم من أعظم القاسم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع كرم المولى يا صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إلى حضرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وآله وصحبه الكرام روحي أبائنا وأمهاتنا حضرة أستاذنا أستاذ أستاذنا والصديقين على نية القبول الفاتحة بسم الله بقل إيتي على بركة الله